Welcome to Darksiders 2. My name is Paprafire. We're going to be playing this on Apocalyptic difficulty. And I did play the first hour of this, but I botched the recording. So I'm going to be replaying it. And then after the first two parts or whatever, then it will be blind again. So originally it was going to be a full blind playthrough on Apocalyptic difficulty, which is what you'll see anyway, so, because the beginning is pretty easy anyway. Sorry, 2 hours.
There can be no life without order. Good, evil, darkness, light. There must be balance in the universe. Such is the decree of the Charred Council, an ancient body charged by the Creator to preserve the very fabric of existence. But the balance has been broken. Even now, Earth smolders in ruin, fallen to the demon lords. And the Destroyer carves a new kingdom amongst his mighty chosen. Some say the Horseman War triggered the apocalypse, that he rode to Earth unbidden and doomed all of mankind. But what of the other Horsemen, fearless enforcers of the Council's will? What of fury, strife, and death? To know those names, you must first know another. Nephilim. Cursed union of angel and demon. The Nephilim had countless realms preserved and burned them to ash. But four amongst them grew weary of the slaughter and feared their conquest would imperil the balance. And so a truce was made. The four would serve the Council in exchange for unimaginable power. Thus were the dreaded Horsemen formed, and the Riders' first task was to purge their own brethren from creation, to annihilate the Nephilim and destroy their souls. Let us now cast our gaze to one amongst the four. Not War, who lies chained at the Council's feet, professing his innocence, but one who would save his brother above all else. He has many names. Kinslayer, Executioner, Death. To bargain for War's freedom, Death swore that he would resurrect humanity. But he knew not how this might be done. And so Death rode forth into the icy veil to find the Keeper of Secrets.
Can I just say I love this music? It's awesome. All right, let's do this. Thank you. trying to make sure that my audio levels are good, because the last time I recorded, they were way off. My aim sensitivity felt very, very fast. Feels much better now.
This is no place for a horse.
I just tried to summon my horse. I guess not. Whatever. Also, awesome looking door. Later. Hey, look, it's Swain. Now, to anyone who's watching that and wondering why I was switching targets so often and attacking different people all at once, was trying to interrupt their attack animation so that they're, less likely to come at me. Because it takes some time to charge up their attacks, so if I'm hitting them at least once, it'll stun them and give me more time to take them out without getting hit. Come on. Also, this guy's pretty easy. Dark Souls would laugh at this game. Didn't even touch me. I honestly don't understand the point of the overly dramatic elevator ride that goes up one story when they could have just had stairs. Okay. Well, I guess I can't leave. Later. Nice looking place. He seems to be pretty certain. Whoops, I meant to hit one. That's gotta hurt.
No!
let's die with you. Old fool.
My secrets. Come on. The uncountable worlds of our universe swirl in an endless abyss. Many worlds ravaged by time or conflict are swallowed by the abyss, returned to the nothingness from which they were formed. But others linger for eternity on the brink of annihilation, that creation might be balanced with destruction. And in the final moment of battle, death was banished to one such world in the autumn of its life, yet not far from the edge of darkness. Had death been sent to his doom? That answer would be found in the horseman's future and in his past.
Be still, horseman. You are wounded. Your arrival here is a bad omen. Yes, troubles me greatly.
Old one, there's more trouble ahead if you don't start making sense. Where is the Tree of Life?
Life? This world is dying, lad. Choking on chaos and corruption. We can do little to stop it. Soon, the great tree too shall perish, and with it, the last of my people. Is that not what brought you here, Pale Rider?
I seek the tree, for chaos and corruption don't concern me.
It seems we do concern. Fight well, but this corruption can't be beaten with a blade. Seek out the Forged Sister. Ask her about the fire of the mountain. Help her, and she will help you reach the tree. As for me, I must return to my work.
So the reason I didn't use a health potion there is because I really don't need it. I can take about one or two more hits, and that'll need it. I'm trying to be kind of conservative, because I know I'm going to need them for boss fights, probably.
And who are you to command a rider?
I am a maker, older than even the Charred Council. These hands have laid the foundations of many worlds, but that was long ago, and now they but hardly know the touch of stone.
What's interesting here is that his skin on his fingers really don't match the skin on his face, which is pretty creepy, because his fingers match his hair better than his face.
Are you not curious as to why I seek the tree?
I would not presume to question one of the four, but yes, tell me.
I must restore humanity to redeem war.
Heaven and hell battle upon the shattered earth. All creation trembles, and at the center of it all stands your brother.
He is innocent.
I never said he wasn't. The tree holds power over life and death. If you would resurrect humanity, then you are headed in the right direction. Be warned. A dark presence dwells now within the tree, and the path is barred by corruption.
I also knew I was going to level up, so that saved me on having to use an HP potion. These look significantly better than the other ones. Also, that ends this first part. Thanks everyone for watching. I will see you in the next episode of Darksiders!